Hare Krishna. Welcome back to the series of discussing Bhagavad Gita. So today we shall be discussing text 15 from the 12th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Om Jnanati Mirandasya Jnananjana Chalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्चा कृपा सिंधुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे Hare Krishna. So the text 15th is Yasmanno dvijate loko lokanno dvijate chayah harsham rishabhayo dvighayar mukto yasachame priya. Translation: He by whom no one is put into difficulty and who is not disturbed by anyone, who is equipoised in happiness and distress, fear and anxiety, is very dear to me. So here, Krishna is further describing three more qualities of devotee. He by whom no one is put into difficulty. That means a devotee of the Lord does not plot or plan to put others in difficulties. We see in the lives of Vaishnavas, described in Srimad Bhagavatam, Pandavas went through so much turmoil or so many difficulties at the hands of Duryodhana and his party. But they never plotted to put Duryodhana in trouble. They were always friendly. And Krishna also says, Lokon no dujate chaya, who is not disturbed by anyone. So generally, Vaishnavas are not disturbed, even though apparently people who are inimical towards Vaishnavas, causelessly inimical towards Vaishnavas, they try to create disturbance, but the Vaishnavas are not disturbed by the dint of their consciousness being totally fixed on Krishna. They are unaffected by even the so-called disturbances created by non-devotees. You know, Prahlad Maharaj went through so much persecution or tortures at the hands of his father. In one of the instances where Shukracharya takes upon himself to correct Prahlad, so he takes Prahlad to his school and he tells Hiranyakashipu that if he is not able to, because Hiranyakashipu tried to kill Prahlad in so many ways. Because he couldn't kill him, he was very disturbed. So Shukracharya said, all right, I will try to correct his mentality. If I cannot, then I will kill him. So Hiranyakashipu was very pleased with Shukracharya's these words. So Shukracharya took Prahlad to his ashrama and tried to correct him, but he did not. Because Prahlad had such unflinching devotion to Krishna. Shukracharya wanted him to leave devotion to Krishna under the order of Hiranyakashipu. But Prahlad would not budge from his determination. Only fault of Prahlad Maharaj was he was fixed in devotion to Lord Krishna. So Shukracharya made a plot. He actually performed a tantric yajna, by which a kritya was supposed to be produced from the yajna. Kritya is kind of a female demoness. She, when produced from this tantric yajna, will kill the object for whom it has been created. So Shukracharya actually performed this tantric rite or yajna, and a kritya was created to simply employ against Prahlad, to kill Prahlad. So he had employed his two sons, Shanda and Amarga, to perform this tantric yajna. He himself left the ashram instructing his sons. So these two sons of Shukracharya, they actually performed this rite, and Kritya was produced, and she tried to kill Prahlad in so many ways. But Prahlad was protected by Lord. He couldn't be killed. Now, the drawback in the tantric rites is the object, if he is not harmed, then the host who created that Kritya will be harmed. So Kritya, when she was frustrated, she couldn't kill Prahlad, she attacked on Shanda and Amarka and she killed both of them. So both the sons of Shukracharya were killed by Kritya. And when Shukracharya returned to the ashram, he saw his sons killed. He was so distressed. He was so unhappy. He started weeping and crying. And he was telling Prahlad, "You must be very happy. You must be very delighted that my sons are killed." And Prahlad was so much distressed hearing these words. He told Shukracharya, "My dear Gurudev, you are earnestly accusing me. I am not at all happy seeing the death of my teachers. Only an unfortunate person would be very happy seeing the distress of his teachers." So Prahlad Maharaj actually prayed to Lord, "Lord Krishna, my dear Lord, please, if I have any trace of devotion, please revive these two sons of Shukracharya." And the Lord was very much obliged by the prayers of Prahlad Maharaj. And the Lord actually revived the two sons of Shukracharya. So just imagine, Shukracharya was, without any consideration, willing to put Prahlad Maharaj to death. He didn't even consider what will be the distress he would be causing to the mother of Prahlad. Prahlad's father, Hiranyakashipu, was anyway inimical towards Prahlad. He would have been very happy hearing the death of Prahlad. But his mother, Kayadhu, would have not been very happy. So Shukracharya was not at all considerate on this fact. But Prahlad Maharaj couldn't see his spiritual master Shukracharya in distress. He prayed to Krishna to revive these two dead sons. Although they had employed a deadly, weapon in the form of Kritya to kill him. So this is the meaning of what Krishna is explaining here. Loka anodhujate loko, yasma anodhujate loko, loka anodhujate chaya. He by whom no one is put into difficulty and who is not put in difficulty by anyone. And also, one more quality is he is equipoised in happiness and distress, fear and anxiety. To be equipoised in happiness and distress and in fear and anxiety is again only possible for a person whose mind is fixed on Krishna. Now, Prahlad Maharaj went through so much so many ways, his father tried to kill him, but he was completely equipoised, fixed in remembrance of Krishna. So these are the sum and substance of this verse. This is another three quality that Krishna mentioned in this verse. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.